researchers working on the Integrated Crop Pollination Project are examining the effect of pollination on the yield of specialty crops, including blueberry, apple, cherry, almond, watermelon, and pumpkin. In this video, Rufus Isaacs, the director of the Integrated Crop Pollination Project, and a professor in the Department of Entomology at Michigan State University, will explain exactly how they can connect different levels of pollination with blueberry yield.
So this is a blueberry bush at one of the farms where we've been doing the integrated crop pollination work for a few years. And we have three different shoots that are marked on here. You can see this one, and then one over here with a bag on it. And this is the experimental setup that we have for this project in blueberry, where we're trying to understand the relative contribution of different pollinators and how they affect yield of blueberry. Okay, so we came out here before blueberry bloom and we selected shoots with approximately the same number of flowers on them. And we put these different colored tags on here to provide us with the count. So this one had 35 flowers just before it bloomed. We could count those flowers, and then that progressed through the bloom period with the flowers opening and bees visiting, and then we can come back after bloom to each of these treatments and count how many of the flowers turned into fruit. So that gives us fruit set. And then we can come back at harvest time, and at harvest time we can pick berries, weigh them, count the number of seeds, and look at how those different treatments related to pollination and crop yield. So there's three treatments. Let's start with the bagged one. So the bagged one, the flowers are excluded from pollinators. So this is what would happen if we had no bees, no insects visiting the flowers, sort of the baseline level of yield. And then we have this orange one. So this orange one was open to bees during bloom. So this is what the grower's investment in pollinators, in terms of honeybees at this site and also the wild pollinators, this is what they provided. And then this third one is our supplemental treatment. So this is where we actually came out, the students that work on this project came out during bloom, and they collected pollen from flowers. So they actually use a toothbrush and hold it up to the flower. The pollen comes out. They put it on the stigma of these open flowers. And with this, we get to see the maximum level of pollination, because we're adding pollen even on top of whatever the bees could provide. So if we see a difference between this one and this one, we know that there's more potential pollination that could be provided. And that's a potential limitation in pollination that maybe with some habitat management for pollinators, or adding more other kinds of pollinators, or even increasing the number of honeybees, the grower could get more like this situation than this situation. So those are the three treatments, and by comparing the three of them, we can get some insights into how much pollination is provided in this situation and how much pollination could be provided with the supplemental treatment.
Project ICP's research into the pollination and yield of blueberries and other specialty crops is ongoing. Follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date as we learn more about the best integrated crop pollination strategies for different crops.